मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू मैथ्स ट्रैक वन सेशन। इन द लास्ट क्लास आई गेव यू फॉर्मुलस एज वेल एज एक्सरसाइज 2.5 फर्स्ट रोमन्स फ्यू सम्स आई हैव टॉट टू यू। ओके, सो चिल्ड्रेन गेट रेडी विथ फॉर्मुलस ऑलवेज, बिकॉज फॉर्मुलस आर मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज द कंप्लीट एक्सरसाइज इज कंप्लीटली डिपेंड अपॉन द फॉर्मुलस ओनली। If you don't know the formulas, you cannot move an inch also. Okay? See here, the second question. Evaluate the following products without multiplying directly. That means, he gave the first question here, 103 into 107. Means, you know how to multiply 103 into 107 very easily. But is asking without actual multiplication. That means you have to use some identity here. See very carefully, children, here. 103 into 107. Actually, if you clearly observe here, both are greater than 100. So, when both are greater than 100, you can write 103 as 100 plus 3, okay, into 107 you can write as 100 plus 7, okay, 103 you can write as 100 plus 3, 107 you can write 100 plus 7. Now if you clearly observe, the first terms are equal, that means you have to know the formula, that is x plus a into x plus b equals to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. So immediately the formula you have to write here. Now write this one here. For clarity you will understand very easily if you write under this formula. 100 plus 3, 100 plus 7. That means you will understand very clearly that x value is 100, a value 3, x value 100, b value 7. That means you have to substitute in the formula x value as 100, that means 100 square plus a means 3 plus b means 7, x means 100 plus a means 3 into b means 7. Okay, so 100 square, that means 100 into 100 is nothing but how much? 10,000, right? 100 square means 100 into 100, that is 10,000, plus 3 plus 7, that is 10. 10 into 100 plus 3 sevens are 21. So 10,000 plus 10 into 100 is 1000 plus 21. Okay, so you should be very care, means you have to take utmost care while doing addition. Okay children, see here, if you want you can go for rough work or in easy way also you can do. I'll tell you the both. 10,000, you have to do the rough work on right hand side. Okay, you have to do the rough work on right hand side. If I do here, I'll hide this question, so that's why I'm doing here. You don't follow this left hand. Okay, right hand side only you have to do the rough work. 10,000 and 21. 1, 2, 0, 1, 1. That means 11,021. Or see here, ones place 1, 0, 1. So 1, 2, 0, 0, 2. Nothing here. So tens, hundreds place 0, 0. Next 1, 1 plus 0, 1. Here 1 left. So you can add like this directly. So 11,021 is the solution for 103 into 107 without using direct multiplication. Okay, see the next sum. I'll give the clue how to do the next sum. Okay, 95 into 96. You can write 100 minus 5 into 100 minus 4. Okay, the same formula you can use with the minus symbols. Similarly, 104 into 96. That means 104 means 100 plus 4 and 100 minus 4. This is a little bit a different formula. So, see the third one here. 104 into 96. Okay. Now, how to write this one? 104. 100 plus 4. Whereas 96 can be written as 100 minus 4. If you write 90 plus 6, it will not come under any formula. So that's why you have to write 100 minus 4. So 100 plus 4 and 100 minus 4. It's looking like, can you tell me? X plus y into x minus y equals to x square minus y square. You may get doubt, sir, why both are same, no? Why you use this formula? You may get doubt. See here both are same. Even the second terms also same with different symbols, that means opposite symbol. Then we have a direct formula, that is x plus y into x minus y equals to x square minus y square. So 100 plus 4 into 100 minus 4. Okay, so 100 square minus 4 square. 100 square means 10,000, 4 square 16. Okay, so 10,000 minus 16. See here, you'll lose your marks here only. Be careful, because in floor you'll write here 6, here 1, 0, 0, 1 you'll write. That is wrong. You have to borrow. So 10 minus 6 is 4. Here it will be 9, here also 9, here also 9. So 9 minus 1, 8, 9, 9. So 9,984 is the solution. Okay? So copy this one in your notebook. Okay? Is it clear, children? So copy the third sum and even first sum also. Now, we'll go for the next round. See the third round, children. Here, you already did this third sum model in 8th standard factorization. But still, you have to be very careful such type of sums. You already know how to do the factors of 3 terms. But by using the formula also, now you have to do it. Because in 2.4 exercise, 4th round, you did how to do factorize splitting term. Okay, that means product of first and third term and you splitted the middle term, right? Same model, but here you have to use the formula. That is only the difference between that question and this question. See here, factorize the following using appropriate identities. That means clearly he mentioned that use identity. Identity means what I gave you, algebraic identities, formulas, those. See the first question. 9x square minus plus 6xy plus y square. 9x square plus 6xy plus y square. See here. 9x square plus 6xy plus y square. If you see the plus symbol here, then you have to understand that is like identity a square plus 2ab plus b square. So a square plus 2ab plus b square. What is that formula? a plus b whole square. That means the question is given according to this. Now we have to convert this one into in this way. That means the given question you have to convert into a plus b whole square. Okay, see how now. It's very easy, children. If you concentrate here, it's very easy sum. And I am telling you, this is the easiest way I am telling to you. Okay, you should know the square roots, then the sum will become very easy. See here. Here, you have to observe the numbers 9. You all know what is the square root of 9, that is 3. Similarly, if x square is there, what is the square root of x square, children? X. Why? Because if you see the degree here, x power 4, that means half of the degree is nothing but the square root for the variables. Okay. Similarly, even for numbers, suppose like 9 square, that means 9 square means 81, so 9 will be. So don't bother this one, just go for the variables. But whereas you may get doubt now, x power 5. Now is it possible to make exactly half? No. So we don't have x power 5 any square root. Such type of sums are given. What to do? I'll tell you. First, learn this sum. Okay. Here I'm telling you, if any even number in the degree, you just make it a half for the variable, you will get the square root for that. Okay. See here, a square, see, I'll write empty brackets. Means a square dash square plus 2ab. 2ab, that means 2 into a into b. I wrote empty brackets, I don't know a and b. Okay, plus b square. That means the same formula I wrote with empty brackets. See here, dash square plus 2 dash a means dash, b means dash, plus b means dash whole square. Now go to the question. What is the square root of 9? 3. What is the square root of x square? X. The same you have to write here. Now, what is the last term you take it here first? Y square. After finishing the first, you have to go to the last term. What is the last term here? Y square. What is the square root of y square? Y. Okay. Now we are AB. That means A means here 3x. The first term here. The second term is here. Okay. That means compare this one with the given question. 3x square. 3x square means 9x square. 2, 3 is 6. 6 into xy. 6xy. Y square. Y square. That means what you wrote it is correct. Now A means 3x. Plus b means y. B means y. So 3x plus y square. That means you ask factors. So 3x plus y. Your square is there now. You have to write 2 times. 3x plus. 3x plus y. So if you multiply these two, you are going to get this answer. So these are the factors for the given question. 3x plus y and 3x plus y. Similarly, if you have any minus symbol here, you can use the same formula but with the minus symbol. Then here also a minus b whole square. Okay. So, children, second Roman, second sum. And third Roman, second and third. Okay. Same formula. You can use the formula identities. Okay. Note on maths homework. Exercise 2.5, second Roman, second question, third Roman 2 and 3. Okay, children. So these are the two sums you have to. Three sums totally. This is the homework. Okay, children. Have a nice day. So till now, what I have told in the today's class, please note down your CW. Don't keep any pending works. Okay. As soon as the school open, we'll ask you to show that. Okay, children. Have a nice day.